My name is Jacqueline Stewart, and I am a professor of cinema and media studies at the University of Chicago. And there, I teach classes in film history, and I do research on early American cinema and African-American cinema. What is the Margaret Herrick Library? The Margaret Herrick Library is the most important resource for the study of American filmmaking, especially the way that American filmmaking has developed as an industry. It was founded in the late 1920s. Margaret Herrick was the first librarian of the Academy. There are books, there are periodicals, clippings, files, posters, something like 10 million photographs, sheet music. I mean, you name it, every aspect of filmmaking is documented at the Herrick Library. And I found the posters for some of the early African-American films to be a real revelation. What kind of people can use the library? Anyone can use the Margaret Herrick Library. It is a place where scholars and teachers do research on film history, but it's also a place where students, journalists, anyone who's interested in the history of film can come and learn more about a title or a director or a star or an aspect of the industry that they want to learn more about. How does the library support diversity? Well, the resources at the Margaret Herrick Library have been incredibly important for my research, especially my research on early African-American filmmaking. So the archives that they have that relate to the distribution of early African-American films, the promotion of those films, and even some of the business records were incredibly helpful to me. You can find the ways in which the librarians there over the years have really attempted to create a complete picture of film history. What is InFrame? InFrame is a cataloging project that was spearheaded by the Academy Film Archive to fill in the gaps in the collecting and preserving of the full spectrum of American filmmaking. We know that there are many, many kinds of contributions that women and people of color have made to the film industry over the last century, but those contributions were not always detailed in the catalog records. And it may not seem that exciting to talk about catalog records, but actually the catalog is sort of the first line, the first point of access for many people to try to understand what's in these film collections. We don't really have a full understanding of our cultural history if we don't take into account this incredibly influential medium.